This week, Heroic Games Launcher brings some cool new features to their project. Plus, aftermarket upgrades, both new and old, for the Steam Deck are on sale. And GuliKit teases some new surprises. What do they have in store? And there's been a series of software updates for the Steam Deck, and we'll look at the biggest changes. All this and more right now. That's right, it's Steam Deck news time. Now, I've been wanting to upgrade my Steam Deck with GuliKit Hall Effect sticks recently. And for those who aren't aware of what these are, the Steam Deck, like most other gaming devices with analog sticks, ship with potentiometer-based analog sticks. Now, potentiometers are inexpensive and work very well until they don't. Most potentiometer-based analog stick designs wear down over time, leading to what's commonly known as stick drift. Now, stick drift can be a minor inconvenience, or it can render a controller unusable. But there is an alternative to potentiometers, and it's called the Hall Effect Sensor. Now, Hall Effect Sensors are already being used in many controllers as a way of measuring analog trigger inputs. But that's where GuliKit comes in. See, they have a Hall Effects-based analog stick module for the Steam Deck. Now, these are highly accurate and are far more resilient when it comes to stick drift. But sourcing these modules right now has proven rather challenging, and it appears other folks have noticed this as well. Diego Ghosh on Twitter asked the official GuliKit account about this, and they retweeted his question, saying, "A new version is coming soon in June." And as if that wasn't enough, though, they also mentioned that they have some, quote, more surprises, too. Whatever that means, it's exciting to hear that there's a new SKU on the horizon, and I'll be picking up the new sticks as soon as they become available. Let me know if you want to see an upgrade video for this, because I would really like to do it. It seems like you guys really enjoyed my SSD upgrade video, so you can check that out up here. Next up, the latest version of Heroic Games Launcher, version 2.8.0, adds some brand new and long-awaited features. Now, if you're not familiar, Heroic Games Launcher is an amazing tool for managing your Epic Games and GOG libraries on Linux, and for Steam Deck players, it's a godsend. The biggest change with this version? Well, the first is the addition of a DLC manager for Epic Games Store. Now, this new UI makes it easy to install or remove any DLC packages for the games that you already own. And another feature that's pretty awesome is support for side-loading browser apps and games. This is really cool, since it gives you the ability to side-load web-based applications into Heroic Game Launcher. For example, Xbox Cloud Gaming is known to work, while Netflix and other DRM-protected content is not quite available yet. And there are several other small fixes and the user experience upgrades that hit with this release as well. Suffice it to say that Heroic is a straightforward, easy to use, and constantly improving tool for accessing other storefronts on Steam Deck and also Linux desktop. But what do you think? What games are in your GOG or Epic library? Sound off below. And while you're down there, why not like that smash button? It's the easiest way to tell YouTube that you want to see more videos just like this one. Now, I want to take a moment and thank Marcus Batson for his continued support in the work that I'm doing here. It's because of Marcus and the other folks that support what I do here that I'm able to keep these lights on, and we have a lot of lights, so thank you. If you believe in the work that I'm doing and you want to see this show grow, use the links below to pledge your support. Next up, it's time for my monthly plugin recommendation. For those not in the know, there's a growing catalog of community-made plugins for Steam Deck. It's one of the ways that the Deck is simply more of a compelling platform than other handheld PCs. This month, I wanted to touch on MangoPeel, a Decky Loader plugin that lets you customize the Deck's performance overlay. Now, if you're not familiar, the performance overlay is actually an open source project called MangoHUD. And MangoPeel, the plugin that we're talking about today, gives you a simple to use game mode interface for customizing the info displayed in MangoHUD. See, you can show or hide information in the overlay using this UI, and if you're into tweaking and optimizing performance, then this is an essential plugin for managing your Deck. All right, next up, apparently this 2 terabyte SSD from Micron is working very well for some Deck users out there who've tried it. This 2 terabyte 2230 NVMe is quite the tempting upgrade, especially if you've been looking to maximize the space available on your Steam Deck. Now, I only recently upgraded my Deck to this 1 terabyte drive, so I'll be holding off for now. But if you're interested, you can use the links below in the pinned comment to grab either one of these upgrades. There's also this 1 terabyte SanDisk SD card that's on sale right now too. I'd recommend this if you want to upgrade but you don't want to have to take your Steam Deck apart. There's a link in the pinned comment for this as well, and these are affiliate links just so you're aware. Next up, Valve has a small update for Proton Experimental that offers fixes for many games. This new update includes a new version of DXVK, which translates Direct3D 9, 10, and 11 to Vulkan. Now, this update is meant to address a regression that hit with a previous version of Proton, and according to the changelog, quote, many games were fixed by this small update, with only Blaze Blue Centrifugation and Kung Fu Strike the Warrior's Rise mentioned by name. However, this new Proton Experimental adds support for many more games, including Super Bomberman R, Minecraft Legends, Company of Heroes, Battle of Crete, and others. There's a whole host of game-specific fixes as well, too. Finally, let's talk about the changes that have hit the Steam Deck's software. On Friday, we actually saw a beta channel update that included a feature I've been waiting to see for weeks. See, game mode now includes initial support for notes in the overlay. Currently, there's support for basic editing, but more advanced formatting features have yet to be implemented. Now, if you don't know what notes are a way for you to literally take notes about the game that you're playing. This is a feature that was added to the new Steam desktop overlay, and I've been waiting with bated breath for weeks to see this actually show up on the Steam Deck. Now, there are other updates with this beta as well. Most of them were fixes for issues found throughout the upcoming desktop mode, as we mentioned. Then on May 30th, there was another beta channel update. This time they added a bell icon to the header and a green indicator for new notifications. They made it so that notification settings for the notification feed can now be set in client from the settings panel, and there was a fix for correctly displaying errors while launching a game. Then there were also fixes for rumble support on DualShock controllers as well as other Steam input changes. Then on Wednesday there were two updates. The first was a fix for an issue where when browsing with the built-in web browser, these web pages would only be restored if the tabbed browser was pinned or when the tab browser was made visible. And then there was a stable SteamOS update, version 3.4.8. This includes two major updates. First, there was an updated graphics driver with a fix for a GPU crash in Splitgate, as well as a change in the graphics driver, which included performance improvements for Star Wars Jedi Survivor. Then, just before I was about to finish this video, Valve released a new Steam beta client update on Thursday. The major feature addition here is the ability to decide whether Ready to Play should include streaming and whether the local computer should be the default in details. On the desktop, it defaults to true, and on Steam Deck, it defaults to false. And this update added a bunch of fixes as well. Now, all things considered, this has been a healthy week of updates for the Steam Deck's software, proving once again that as the hardware of the deck ages, it actually grows both more performant and more usable. But I want to know what you think about any of the news stories that we talked about in this video, or did I miss a story? Let me know. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Well, that's going to do it for the Steam Deck news this week. I want to shout out my friends on Patreon, my YouTube members, and our ViewSync Premium members who make what we do here a reality. If you believe in the work that I'm doing, you can use the links below to show your support, and thank you. That's going to do it for now, though. Thank you so much for spending your time with me here today, and I'll see you guys in the next one.